Hello everyone, welcome back to the saga, and this is where we left off in the last episode. We finished a bunch of terraforming over on the other yonder way, and now this way here, yonder, we have some more stuff that we've been working on. The water was all the way in here, and we got rid of that. None of that going on. I got rid of this strange canopy that was going on over here, and if I get over there, we can see that I basically put a sort of a thick strip along the of dirt. That's what this is, dirt along the edge of any previous level I put down before it, and that sort of gives me room for the next level when I start putting it on. Like, probably do something like this. And then I'll put dirt behind that a little bit so that the next level can go up. And I'm thinking that I'll probably have this go. Part of the reason why I took all these trees out is because I want to keep this going. And this is a little bit too flat for my liking. So I'm gonna fix this up. I showed a lot of my process the last time around, so I'll probably just do a few really quick updates so we can kind of get through this. Not that I'm in a rush, but I've been deciding to get just tons of enchanted stuff, and I'm trying to get a collection of things that I would ever need for big build projects where I just don't have the levels or I don't really want the time to level up things. So I went off into the Nether and got a bunch of this, and I've been having sessions where I've been enchanting stuff. And tables down there. I just grab the fortune, and yeah, I basically want to have like a full chest. This is just a reminder of how many shovels, like how long it takes to get some of these enchants. But I'd like to get a full chest of just rows of, like, where's a good one? Of these with fortune, these with silk touch, these with fortune and silk touch and unbreaking. Just get like the best equipment and like armor too and books. You know, why not? Just make it so that I can soup up some of these easier. So that's kind of a an on the side project. So I guess it's a side project. You don't really call them on the side projects. So I'll get back to you the next update. So what I did is I kind of filled out some of the curves over here and brought this mountain closer and sort of made a ridge along here. And kind of left some of the low area there because I thought it was kind of an interesting thing to have. And I kept building up the sides, and this sort of became the big lookout. This point used to be like around here when I was looking down before, so now I'm looking down into this hill if I had the exact same view. And I kind of made it a big hill that sloped down that way, but in between them, I put this. And it's kind of similar to the gap in the other area, further that way. But I thought that, well, since there's a cool hill here, it'd be kind of fun to have a passageway through. And I'm not really sure why I wanted to be here yet. I just like the fact that it kind of empties out into this area. And then you get a nice view of this bay. So maybe something will go in here eventually. Not entirely sure. I'm starting to think maybe this will go just to have an entryway into the bay. And that's another question is this seems to be a bit of an isolationist village, seeing as there's the wall there. But maybe that's just for protection and they still allow ships to come in. So, going along here, I decided to have this hill slope down more and more. Don't worry, I hear it. almost like it originally didn't have a gap in the middle, but now that the gap is there, it sort of happened later, and it kind of goes into where the tree felling area was, which is right here. And let's get a better view. On top of the wood pile. So I like this. I think this is a more realistic than that very flatness that was happening before. Like, nothing wrong with flatness, but only in moderation. But even moderation in moderation, so go do what you want with that. But I decided to make this little a couple lookouty type points, sort of raised ground areas. Not necessarily sure what I'm going to do with them. One's here and one's up there. There could be a building. I think I might actually go ahead and put some type of a church for the town or some sort of thing there. Whatever this town may want. But it's kind of higher up, and I think it could be a cool thing to have risened up over there. But yeah, long story short, blocks have been blocked, torches have been torched, and the land has landed. Oh, and I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of take a peek in here. I think I'm going the wrong direction. Here we go. And just for funsies, this is all of the, this isn't all the way down to the bottom like it was before. I took out a lot of the dirt that was toward the bottom. But as you see, like we're underneath the point I was standing on earlier if we're over there. And this is sort of the underside of all of the mountains that have been made. And there's actually quite a bit of space under here, as happens whenever you make your own mountains. So if there was a church at the high spot, which is right about here, there's a lot of underground area. So maybe there's secrets underneath. I'll have to think about that. Anyways, I'm gonna go back up. Like I said, I finished the terraforming, and I think that with that finished, the whole town is ready for the next step. But I don't think I have enough time really in this episode, and plus I want to show a little bit of the footage, or actually quite a bit of the footage, from taking out that ocean monument. So I'm gonna play that now with limited breaks or interruptions, because I don't think I've really done an upload like that in a bit. So without further ado, here it is. All right, this is what my inventory looks like now as I get ready for this. Key notes here are Depth Strider 3 on the boots and Respiration 3. Although with water breathing, I don't think that's going to be an issue. And night vision, superpower notched apple. I got four boats just in case anything goes wrong. I don't think this is going to become that useful underwater. And this just for when I finally kill everything. The effects wear off. And I got more stuff just in case I run out. I don't know. I've never done this solo before. So, taking on an ocean monument. Let's find out. And I didn't mention I also have this because it's always good to have some blocks on you. Well, this is the most peninsula-y point. Probably the most southmost of town. So, this is a good spot to start. Into the great blue yonder. Not very sure where anything will be, so I'm just gonna kind of back and forth it. If that doesn't make any sense, let's rephrase that. So, I'm gonna keep an eye out. And hopefully not stray too far into an area that I have no idea where I'm going. Since it's nighttime, hopefully those underwater lanterns will show a little better in the water. But I'm not really sure what I'm going to find. I'm just going to head straight off, and I believe it's the southern direction. Oh, wow. Stop. I believe that is, wow, that was like right south. Wait, what? So, okay. I believe we found it. So, I usually also bring a bed. I knew I threw out something. Sleeping. But since we don't have one, let's just abandon ship. Let's see. I think everything's in our inventory. Oh, we're gonna have friends. So, what I'm going to do, whoa, is I'm going to eat this. Drink this. Do this. And let's go. Depstrider is truly amazing. Let's not waste time. We know what we're here for. Don't focus on the small fry. I think knockback is not going to help as that much. Guys are strong. Sharpness 7. I mean, whatever. Sharpness whatever. Doesn't seem to cut it. Sharpness 4. So I hear it. This is the quest. Sort of a deep, ominous sound. Get out of here. Made a sheep. I mean, oh, there's that. Oh, because you're right here. Okay. Only you dropped something. Something fun. I think. Is regen still going? Absorption still going. I'm regenning. It's fine. Oh, I love running underwater. Oh, okay. Found another one. I was about to say the perimeter looks pretty secure. Die. Yes. Get out of here. And one more. Where are you? I hear you. Where are you? Come out wherever you are. Come out and play. Oh, not you. That's how much time I'm wasting on those guys. I think it was already up here. Oh, you're. I thought you were following me. All right, so this is the gold room. That's good. Nothing in here, nothing over there. Starting to think that knockback is actually like aggressively bad, like it's working against me way more than for me. How are things? Looking pretty good. That is a silly noise. Make no mistake. Oh, this is kind of an interesting room. So this is invariably what happens. The quest for the final thing. Oh yeah, don't waste time on the small fry. They are small fry. thought there'd be at least one in here. This is like an Easter egg hunt. It's like a bad Easter egg hunt. You just want to find it. My stuff's gonna run out. This is the only reason why my things are gonna run out, is because I can't find anything. Oh well, I got it all. I got the things. All I care about, night vision, yada yada. Maybe I should have this ready, just in case. Just in case I need it. I'm about to get that ghost thing to pop up again. The first time I saw that, I remember that very vividly. I'm taking out my aggression on these guys. Ooh, I'm so startled. Actually, that is really scary if you're not expecting it. Like, really, really scary. Maybe I need to go down. Just like hating him as I walk past. I just really want to find this last one. Well, time to go for round two. First round's on me, second round's on me! I'm not really too worried about the apple anymore. I wonder how mining fatigue affects. I don't have 3 and aqua affinity. Not aqua affinity. Underwater mining? Yeah, it's terrible. Never mind. I wonder if you had haste 2 beacon with efficiency 5 pick. If that would stand a chance. Now, if this was a cave, I would have put torches on the left, and I could be able to find my way out. Since it's underwater, I totally could have did that with dirt blocks, couldn't I? Just marked my way. Alright, whatever. Live and learn. I've been down that corridor 5 times now. It's about time I start learning. But that's the only way out. What the hell? Oh, hey, hello. Hello there. Good day. Very good day. I can't do anything about it. It's good to know that's right there, right next to the gold room. Wait a minute, there's no way in or out of here. It's just those two. It's just what? How did I get in here? That's a dead end. That's a dead end. What? And every once in a while, I get a short, sharp shock. How did I get in here? Okay. The sponge room. The nothing. Oh, wait. Not nothing. I forget up and down. Where are my manners? Okay. Easy. That one got me. Oh, game. You do talk. Get out of here. I said get out of here. I came from this way. Okay, I came from there. I wonder if the Ocean Monument was inspired by the Water Temple in Zelda directly. Just as far as navigational fun. Boom. Oh, I didn't hit it. Whatever. Boom. 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 I guess I don't have to add a sound effect because it's pretty silly on its own. So can I go up? Can I eat? Maybe on all of those? How did I get in here? Huh. Oh, yay! Yay! I still need to find the other one, though. Let's sprint swim. Don't get picked on as much. I'm gonna have this one ready. Think I'm okay, but I never know. Now. Is there an area I'm missing? Kind of. An under area. Perhaps. Oh, maybe I need to eat this. Oh. Game over. You're fired. Wow, that was my first death in the series. Wow, I've so many people to thank. My parents are buying me this game, and that's about it. They didn't buy it for me, actually. They don't know I play it. Maybe they do. Right, so here's a life decision. Back to my scratch. Well, here's the thing. There are my supplies over there, so I can get them. I think I should load up first, though. I think that's an amateur mistake to go in and think that you can get them all back. That was really stupid, though. I should have had watched my hearts better. I let them get way too low, and that was stupid. I had notch apples, and I couldn't eat it in time. I couldn't eat it in time. Time! Your clock! All right, I'm gonna round up my stuff around here. All right, so let's strategize this a little bit. The way I see it is I just need enough to get to my gear, and then I can start powering up from there. So I would need to withstand any initial blasts from the foe. And luckily I died outside of the monument, so it's not somewhere in the maze. I think I have a good chance of getting to it, but I need to get there with need enough protection. I basically need to tank myself, or think tank-like. Become tank-like. Tanky. I might even bust out the diamonds just to just to get a set of armor for situations exactly like this. Oh, I have no levels. Wait a minute. Oh, pshaw. And all of these. I was so ready. Oh, but Netherrack though. But Netherrack. Oh. My savior. In times of trouble, speaking words of wisdom. To the tune of like a level every like four blocks. Maybe more. All right. My loadout is a little bit different this time. As you can see, it's kind of minimalistic, but I have a very good reason for all of these. I got some basic stuff on these, but I mainly just wanted, like, I was happy to get the protection four on that, but I just wanted to have a full set. I'll probably make this better as time goes, but I think this will get me to the spot. I'm getting around the water breathing with torches that I'll place in the wall to make air pockets, and I think this golden apple is going to be enough for me to get to just power my way to my gear. So once I get my gear, this will fill up really fast. So that's the strategy. I'm going to park the boat right above where I think I'm going to be. Where I think I'm going to be. Where my stuff is last disappeared. I'm going to eat the notch apple, and I'm just going to go for it. Just go straight for my stuff. All right, there's the last boat. A chilling reminder of the crushing defeat from before. All right, apple's going in. I'm getting close. Incoming, ghost. Yep. Okay. It's about here. Abandon ship. Whoa, knock me around. Yes, I found it. Oh, that couldn't have worked more perfectly. Give me air pocket. Air pocket. Okay. Okay, sort through my stuff quickly. Water breathing. Okay, everything else is here. Heart pounding. Not gonna worry about you guys. That was the hardest part. Getting my gear. Night vision. I can see. Let's get these other apples over here. Depth strider, please. Thank you. And right now these are the superior. Where's my helmet? I don't know. Fish. Stone. I can move. I can move now. Sponge. The most important. Torch. Honorable mention. Good fighting. Good job out there. I thought this was going to be a way in, but it is not. I still have the previous problem. I have my gear. I just... Wow, I'm having trouble, apparently. Maybe I can't hang out up here and play with these guys. They fight kind of rough. I'm going to go back inside now. Let's see. I'm like sorting as I go also. All right, back into the temple. Where was I? What? It's a weird noise. All right, I'm going to do what I didn't do last time. And actually have markings to show my way. You bastard. I want to kill you. I mean... If I've explored an area, I'm cutting it off. Simple as that. This is how I will narrow it down. Do I not have water breathing? I do. Okay. Good. Alright, so this leads back. That'll be my reminder to go up, I guess, hopefully. Alright, I've already dealt with this room. I get myself a full tank of water. Yeah, sponge room. Yeah, I don't need to go in here yet. So it's getting blocked off. There are not very many ways to go, apparently. Oh, I can go up. I can go up. Hope this means the bad guy's somewhere close. Maybe. Definitely hear it. Really? Nothing? Oh! Okay. Yeah, you just had to get me that last second, didn't you? You jerk. Well, if that doesn't wear off... Eh, whatever. So what I could do is I can take these milk if I want. This milk. Get rid of the mining fatigue. But it also gets rid of everything else. I do have notch apples. I'll just be blind. And I won't be able to breathe underwater. Oh, this wasn't the place. I have to remember where the room was. I think it was in here. Oh, yes, here it is. Get, come, come over here. Okay. Ah, here we are. Just getting that sweet sponge. Spongetastic. Yeah, while I'm here, might as well get some of the spoils of war, which is gold. And let's see. There goes my resist. All of my damage keeping awaying stuff. Now that I have the sponges, which is the main reason I want to come here, next thing I need to do is get out. Can I make a mad dash and leave this place? I think I can. I know how to get out. Leave and never return. Nah, I'll probably be back. There's a lot of cool stuff in here. Yeah, get out of here. Go that way. All right, so once I exit, it's gonna be bad. I don't think I can do anything except just run for it, so I'm gonna go run for it. Yeah, get out of here. All right, that wasn't so bad. Time to dolphin kick my way to the boat and get out of here. Sayonara! All in all, I think that was a success. I would have liked to not dying. Not dying. Dying kind of hurt, but it just made the mission of retribution so much better. To like come back and get my gun back, all my guns. You know, that the thrill of that. Good stuff. I like it. A hero's welcome. Welcome, hero. Fireworks, oh lovely. This has been Red McNed, so long.